ladies and gentlemen, we're back real quickly.
Agent Orange came out of nowhere. Like we said, he's got the title shot next week. Why can't he just wait?
He's got the belt
next week.
He's got the belt, and he's trying to use it on Rambling Rich. Wait a minute, is he going to take it? Is that what he's going to do?
Spoiling a very sweet victory for Rambling Rich. Rambling Rich won it fair and
he's
square.
He's got the belt. Where's he going with that belt?
Agent Orange came out and stole the title. He's got a title shot next week. Why can't he wait?
Dave, I can't believe this. Rambling Rich is flat out on this hardwood floor here. Joe DiCarlo, see if he can give some assistance. We don't know what's going on, but Dave, the way we need to find out.
Weighing in at 287 pounds from the daycare center, here is Big Baby Donnie! Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, 300 pounds from Jamaica, here is Rasta, the Voodoo Man.
Hello everyone and welcome to another action-packed edition of UIW Universal Independent Wrestling. Dave the Wave here along with Mike Paradise in our first match.
Dave the Wave, this is one of the more bizarre sights I've seen. Seriously.
I don't know if bizarre is the word. Scary. This guy just plain scares me.
But Big Baby Donnie comes out with a
bottle.
A bottle, yeah.
A little diaper bag.
And some lullaby music. And here's Rasta the Voodoo Man.
I have a feeling Baby Donnie is going to wish he was back in the crib.
But do you think this is a
after
psych job
he deals
here, Dave?
With Rasta.
You think he's just trying to set up Rasta?
But I don't think so. I don't think he has it in him.
And as you can see, ladies and gentlemen,
he
has Crybaby proudly displayed on the back of his trunks.
Well, he may be in tears after this one. Oh, picked him up!
Shoo!
Brute force by the throat and just dumped him down.
And I don't know whether he's trying to go into a tantrum or not, Dave the Wave.
He better do something, because Rasta the Voodoo Man is nothing to play around with. This isn't one of your little playmates, Baby Donnie.
And I think maybe Rasta might be angry from our previous show here, Dave the Wave, last week's show, when he lost his Jamaican walking stick.
To the surgeon.
Which was quite a match in itself.
If it is a walking stick, some say it has mystical powers. Who knows?
Well, we'll see if he can work some Jamaican mysticism on Big Baby Donnie here. I was ready to call him the Crybaby again.
Well, not much mysticism there, just plain brute strength by Rasta. He picks him up by the tights. Forearm shot. Well, I know we definitely haven't seen the end of it between the surgeon and Rasta the Voodoo Man.
No, I don't think that's
because
something.
Because Rasta does not take too kindly to people touching his stick.
No, he will not
me.
Forget, and especially now the surgeon smashed that thing into three pieces across Rasta's back. So that is something I don't think the Voodoo Man will have any trouble remembering.
Just hope for the surgeon's sake that Rasta doesn't decide to construct a little voodoo doll and perform some surgery of his own with needles.
That's entirely possible. Now, Big Baby Donnie here hasn't been off the match much.
Oof,
that much in this.
The voodoo vice. It's over. That's it. Once he clamps it on.
And, well, I don't
know
there.
You're lucky enough for him to let go.
He's got
him.
Is it a choke hold now? Or?
I don't know. I can't tell.
I thought it was a three count there, Dave the Wave, and I can't tell either.
Digging into, threw the ref. That's money out of his pocket.
Okay, and the Voodoo Man doesn't want to be bothered here.
Let's go back and take a look at it.
He's got that eye, Dave the Wave.
There you see the voodoo vice. He clamps it in, digs and, into the temple.
And we're waiting for...
And that's it.
We're waiting. And here's the decision now, Dave the Wave. From Jim
Ladies
Diller.
And gentlemen, the winner by disqualification, Big Baby Donnie.
Well, Dave the Wave, it's hard to make heads or tails out of that one, but the voodoo man must have shifted that into some kind of illegal home, and that must be it. But we'll find out more about it and be back with you right after these messages.
Hey, you, sitting there watching this pro wrestling show, did you ever wonder how guys like Kirk Dredd, the War Pig, Axel Rotten, and the other UIW stars got into wrestling? Here's your answer. They attended the Pro Wrestling Training Center in Hanover, Pennsylvania. This facility can make you the next UIW star. Call the owner, Phil Leivelsberger, at 717-633-9542 and get started in your new exciting career. Stop watching and be watched. Join the Pro Wrestling Training Center now.
Attention wrestling fans, here's your chance to add all the great UIW action to your home video library. Universal Independent Wrestling is now available on video cassette. Each action-packed tape contains one exciting hour of UIW matches and interviews as seen on TV, all for the incredibly low price of $14.95. Just send $2 in a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on your screen to receive your catalog of all the great UIW action now available to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next match is scheduled for one fall. First introducing, entering the ring at this time, from Asbury Park, New Jersey, he is the Beast from the East, weighing in at 410 pounds. Here is Bam Bam Bigelow. His opponent, weighing in at 232 pounds, from Palm Beach, Florida, and Scotty the Body Anthony.
Self-proclaimed Palm Beach heartthrob, Scotty the Body Anthony, making his way to the ring.
And one of the great names in wrestling, Dave the Way, Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East. This should be a great match, ladies and gentlemen. The UIW is real proud to present this one this evening. And we're really looking forward to it, right, Dave?
I don't know if Scott Anthony is looking forward. He's giving Joe DiCarlo some lip. Oh, ran
oh,
into
there
the
we go.
That was all a psych job. Scotty the Body Anthony, known to psych out his opponents with that,
and he
with
put that
nonstop mouth of his.
He put that shoulder right into Bam Bam's knee. And
oh,
he
don't
no
think
headbutt
so.
With Bam Bam Bigelow.
Ooh,
that's what a headbutt looks like, Scotty. And Scott Anthony takes the refuge outside
he
the
tried.
Ring.
He tried. You have to give him
yeah.
credit there.
Well,
he tried.
Hey, it was worth a shot, right, Dave?
He's on the outside now. Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East, with that unmistakable tattoo on his head, bringing Scotty in the hard way, pressing him above his head like a barbell. Getting ready to dump him. Ooh.
And I think Scott tried to eye gouge or gave him a shot to the head there.
Smart Bam move on his part, saved himself.
Checking his eye there. And here comes Scott with a foot to the stomach. And a couple of shots to the head on Bam Bam Bigelow.
Oh, I don't think so.
Come on, Scott.
Scotty the Body may have an impressive physique, but I don't think
he's got a sore back to go with it,
Dave. He's got the strength to pick up Bam Bam.
That's how it's done, Scott.
Another headbutt.
And Bam Bam, oh.
Two in a row, right to the right shoulder of Scotty the Body. Bam Bam Bigelow, an international star. He's wrestled in Japan, all over the world. It's good to have him here in the UIW.
It certainly is, Dave, the way. And Bam Bam Bigelow giving us one heck of a match. Scotty the Body Anthony, a game competitor, to say the very least.
Some of the fans might recognize him from the Global Wrestling Federation. Can be seen every afternoon on ESPN. Coming from the Dallas, Texas area, Scotty doing quite well for himself down there, but I guess he heard about the UIW maybe from Craig Johnson.
Maybe so, Dave the Wave. Scott's might be a little bit more hurt than we thought. He's got a little bit of blood there around the mouth, Dave the Wave. So, oh, we're going to have a test of strength now. And I think Scotty trying another psych job there. Maybe he's getting away with it a little bit.
Trying to kick his way out of this one. Oh, Bam Bam throwing him right into the corner. Charging and misses. Nobody home. Scotty had the presence of mind to drop down, taking advantage of it now.
And he seems to be working on that right side of Bam Bam Bigelow.
Those ribs.
As he alternately delivers a fist and a boot. And now,
trying to wear the big guy down. That's what you got to do. Scott Anthony obviously is at a disadvantage as far as size goes.
And the thing to do, Dave, is to keep him off his feet, right?
Exactly. Scotty the body in control now, kicking and stomping away. That's pretty much his style, straightforward to the point.
Got
Irish whip, elbow.
Oh, and that was a heck of a shot
there. Abdominal stretch.
Look at this.
Trying to go for a submission, perhaps. Don't think he's going to get it from this guy.
No, I don't think so either, Dave the Wave, but you got to give him credit. I mean, he's trying everything here.
Scotty the body, also an accomplished commentator. Wouldn't be surprised if
you think he might sit in with us, Dave?
Tries to sneak in at some point tonight.
We heard a little poetry earlier in the evening.
A rap. He's got a mouth that won't quit.
Well, there you go.
Bam Bam using the hip toss to throw Scotty out.
Gives him a shot to the head there. Whips him into the opposite corner and follows with a body slam. And Scott Anthony,
300 pounds, coming at you at about 30, 40 miles an hour.
Scott Anthony got two steps out of the corner and that was it.
Irish whip by Bam Bam, picks him up, bear hug.
And Bam Bam tightens it one more notch.
Like a vice.
And I think we got a submission here, Dave the Wave.
Referee Joe DiCarlo is going to ask him, checking the arm. That's two. No. Gouging his way out. Scotty the body Anthony from Palm Beach, Florida.
And there he goes. He's working on the ribs on that left side of Bam Bam Bigelow one more time, Dave the Wave. And that may be the best advantage Scotty the body can get.
Maybe he knows something we don't. Maybe that's a weak spot.
That's right. Maybe some intelligence before the match here might have helped him out a little bit.
Reverse anyway. Chin lock. Scotty the body Anthony in control, trying to wear the big guy down again. It's been pretty much back and forth between these two. Still, great to have a match of this caliber in the UIW.
That's for sure. A well-known wrestling name in Bam Bam Bigelow. And Scotty the Body, certainly nothing to sneeze at here, Dave the Wave. A great wrestler in his own right.
Bam Bam using some elbows to get out, charging off. Scotty goes down, hit him with the shoulder block. Scotty drops down again, jumps over. Ooh!
Caught him with a knee right in the solar plexus there.
Could have hit that weak spot again that we saw Scotty working on earlier. Cover!
Ooh. Ooh. Kicks
Talk
out
about
of
a
it.
Kick out. Goes right back to work though.
Exactly.
Not wasting any time.
This would be a classic textbook match for some other wrestlers, Dave the Wave, in that these two guys never quit on each other.
Scotty the body in control once again, this time using the middle rope to choke Bam Bam. He's got a five count.
And Joe DiCarlo gets the wrestler separated there, but Bam Bam is slow in getting up.
Scotty pounding away. Irish whip to the corner. Charges
and he
in.
Tries Ooh. To come in for a body slam. Bam Bam Bigelow will deceive you. He is a very quick man, Dave the Wave.
For someone his size, it's amazing. Ooh, got caught right on the bridge of the nose.
With that elbow from Scotty the Body
in
Anthony.
In the past, I've seen Bam Bam Bigelow do cartwheels in the ring. Amazing. DDT. Scotty put him down.
Scotty, this is no time to
arrogance.
Take a rest.
That's one word to describe this guy. Arrogance. Climbing on the second rope. Going for a splash. Bam Bam put his knees up.
And Scott
caught him right in the abdominal region.
And Bam Bam is up on his feet, and this is not where Scott wants him.
Hard right hand. He's got the, got him reeling. Irish whip. Ooh, another elbow right to the shoulder. Put Scotty down.
And Bam Bam's got a look on his face like he wants to get this finished, Dave, the way.
Ooh, charged in again. Ooh. Scotty, okay. Wait a minute. He's got his feet up on the ropes. No. Wait a minute. That
Scott
was
Anthony
only two.
Thinks he's the
that
winner.
Was only two.
He thinks he's
referee
the winner.
Referee Joe DiCarlo only counted two. Bam Bam from behind. Cradle two, three. He got him.
And that is a true
count
and a legal one, Dave, the wave. So our winner in this match. There you have it from a ring announcer, ladies and
Scotty,
gentlemen.
Scotty, the body obviously confused and thought that the referee counted two.
Obviously confused.
Or three when it was actually only two. He saw that Joe caught him with those feet up on the ropes.
Scotty, the body not being able to tell two from three. And Dave the Wave will be back with more wrestling after these messages.
Hey, you, sitting there watching this pro wrestling show, did you ever wonder how guys like Kirk Dredd, the War Pig, Axel Rotten, and the other UIW stars got into wrestling? Here's your answer. They attended the Pro Wrestling Training Center in Hanover, Pennsylvania. This facility can make you the next UIW star. Call the owner, Phil Leivelsberger, at 717-633-9542 and get started in your new exciting career. Stop watching and be watched. Join the Pro Wrestling Training Center now. Attention wrestling fans, here's your chance to add all the great UIW action to your home video library. Universal Independent Wrestling is now available in video cassette. Each action-packed tape contains one exciting hour of UIW matches and interviews as seen on TV, all for the incredibly low price of $14.95. Just send $2 in a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on your screen to receive your catalog of all the great UIW action now available to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, weighing in at 250 pounds, from the bad side of Baltimore, Rip, rest in peace, Sawyer. He is accompanied to the ring by Diamond Dave Casanova.
Well, there you go, Dave the Wave from Jim Doe there. That's our lineup for this match. And Dave, I have a sneaky suspicion.
This could turn into a tag team match.
Yes.
We've got the bad thing, AJ Fritzoid, out there with Adrian Hall. They make up Sweet and Sour. And those two men right there, Rip, rest in peace, Sawyer, Diamond Dave, Casanova.
The green team.
The green team. Diamond Dave looking quite suave this evening.
There we go.
Rico Suave.
And I think Rip was smart to bring him out there with him. Because we, as
even
we well know.
Out a bit.
Yeah, I think it will. As Rip Sawyer backs up the insatiable one, Adrian Hall, just a little bit. And Dave, I noticed that when they first came out here, Adrian Hall was tossing out flowers and AJ
to the men,
sort
of. Course.
Yes, and AJ sort of tossed one to him, so.
Maybe
I don't know
more than meets the eye to these two. Hopefully not.
Hopefully not. Hopefully they will remain sweet and sour.
No, I can't imagine AJ Fritzoid.
I don't think that'd be sweet and low.
No.
Anyway, so we've got Rip Sawyer here in this match against insatiable Adrian Hall.
One half of the cream team against one half of Sweet and Sour. Adrian Hall, of course, the sweet. side.
Yes.
Well, Ripslayer is sort of the darker side of the Cream Team. There you see, we can't see him now, but he's out there on the outside of the ring, Diamond Dave Casanova.
I don't know
he's
what.
He's smooth, he's cool, he's suave.
There you go.
He gets, you know, he gets the women. He drives the fancy cars. Well, Rip, sort of a.
Rip's sort of a blue-collar guy.
Well, it's not just that. He's, like I said, he's the darker side. He's, he's fascinated with evil. From what I hear, he does a lot of reading on the subject. Evil
and there you go.
Oh.
As he spanks Adrian Hall. And Adrian,
he might
a
have
little upset
it.
Dave the Wave.
He might have liked it. Usually he's the one doing the spanking.
Whoa! It just takes a forearm and pushes him out of the ring.
Oh, right on Diamond Dave!
Diamond Dave gives him a shot. And AJ is standing over there looking rather dapper in his fur coat.
I don't blame him.
Okay, Diamond Dave. Getting a little bit of action going there.
Next week.
All right,
and
here.
Oh, what a coincidence this is. Next week, we have the Bad Thing AJ Fritzoid taking on Diamond Dave Casanova.
Bam Bam Bigelow stops by to give us a goodbye there, who we saw earlier in this hour.
Making his way back to Asbury Park, I presume.
But anyway, Dave the Wave, it's we got a little start here. We've got things a little straightened out, and we know who the players are, and Rip Sawyer's going to take it to Adrian Hall here in this match, it looks like, as he gets ready to set him up for a suplex right over the top. Brings him down hard. There's a cover.
One, two only.
Okay, it comes right back.
Another quick arm drag.
That's Rip Sawyer.
Smart wrestling, staying on that body part, that left arm. Left arm, a favorite of everybody. Very popular body part to work on.
Holds him in that arm bar, brings him up.
Insatiable Adrian Hall. And we're joined here by Bam Bam Bigelow. How you doing, Bam Bam?
Well, I survived.
Yeah, you did. Congratulations on your victory earlier.
Thanks. I tell you, you know, he almost broke my leg there, and it hurt me the whole match. It was hard for
me. We noticed.
Oh, well, we saw where he came in with that head and headed straight for your knee before the match got started there, Bam Bam.
You know, it had nowhere to go, and it almost broke, so, I mean, geez.
I saw you on candid camera. I just wanted to let you know, enjoyed it thoroughly. If a lot of the fans out there, I know if they caught that, it was a classic.
Got some things coming up, a Wendy's commercial.
Oh, great.
A movie out there.
A movie?
Yeah.
With who?
With, it's starring Chuck Norris.
Ah, there you have it, folks. Yeah, give him a headset. Yeah, the inside scoop from Bam Bam Bigelow.
Yeah, we're doing some things. We got the Wendy's commercial coming up, and did you see that?
Yeah. No, I missed it.
Oh, you missed it. And I got a couple movies. I just finished a movie with Lorenzo Lamas called Snake Eater 3, and I do a lot of wrestling in Japan. You know, so that keeps me pretty busy throughout the whole year.
Well, what's this Snake Eater 3?
Yeah, it's a movie that was filmed in Canada starring Lorenzo Lamas, and I played the role of Goose. I was a president of a local motorcycle chapter, and, you know.
Appropriate role, I guess.
Yeah, they kill me in the movie, but they can't kill me in real life, brother.
In the movie. Oh, well.
I got to go. I got to beat
right.
The snow, man.
All right, take it easy.
Be good. Take care, guys.
Be good. Look for him in Snake Eater 3, or was it Snake Biter 3? Bam Bam Bigelow. In the meantime, action going on in the ring.
And
didn't mean to take away from the action there, but
wanted to catch Bam Bam on his way out of the arena.
It is snowing extremely hard.
But anyway,
Rip Sawyer looks like he's in control.
He certainly is in this match, Dave the Wave.
Well,
and
we got
a little conversation
Dave
going on over on the other side.
A match of their own.
Between
the
Fritz
there.
Dave the Wave, I mean, excuse me, Diamond Dave doing his AJ.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. We saw it earlier. Adrian did the same thing for Fritzoid. Fritzoid just returned the favor, grabbed Rip's leg. And now Insatiable Adrian Hall taking advantage, backing Rip into the corner.
A heck of a chop there, Dave the Wave.
Skin right off his chest.
And I'll tell you, Dave the Wave, this is something that Adrian Hall and AJ Fritzoid must be working on here.
Boot to the face. Adrian off the second rope, bulldogs his head right down to the mat as Fritzoid celebrates at ringside.
Leg drop, cover. a two count, and Rip Sawyer gets the shoulder up.
Like we said, folks, next week we'll be seeing Diamond Dave Casanova and take on AJ Fritz Hoyt.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Reversal. Suplex. Oh!
What a move from Rip Sawyer.
Double whammy. Let's call it the double whammy.
Rip Sawyer looked like he got a finger in the eye there. Diamond Dave a little disgusted on the outside of the ring. Seems like he's getting a little pensive there.
A rude awakening for Rip Sawyer, who may have underestimated insatiable Adrian Hall as Adrian Hall climbs the top rope.
Waiting for the right moment.
Flying clothesline.
All right.
That could be it. One, two, oh no. Two count only. Rip able to kick out.
Fritzoid could be happier about this, Dave. He's thrilled to death.
Adrian Hall in control, dropping elbows from Greenwich Village, New York, where the men aren't always men, as evidence right here in the ring. Put his head down. Ooh, mistake. Mistake. Do not put your head down around Rip Sawyer. He will catch you with that leg.
And Rip Sawyer, he's going for the top rope now, Dave, the way.
Lots of high-risk maneuvers in this match. Perching himself. Ooh, flying cross. Wait a minute. Flying cross body block. Adrian was able to go over with the momentum. Small package. He got him with the small package.
He's got him with the small package.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're going to rip Rustampy Sawyer.
There you go. Little disco move there from Rip Sawyer. Dave the Wave, as we get the official announcement there from Jim Doe, our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first in the ring, combined weight 466 pounds, Mr. Hollywood Bob Starr and Beach Boy Vinny Young. Their opponents at a combined weight of 422 pounds, Hard Rock Ricky Blues and Watsumi, the Rising Sun.
Well, Mike, back with more UIW action here in the Parkville Armory. This is an interesting team, two lightweights.
It sure is,
teaming
Dave
up together. I don't mean lightweights in any bad respect. I meant light heavyweights.
But I know one of your favorites,
Hard Rock Ricky Blues. Yes, indeed.
And Watsumi, he's no slouch either, Dave the Wave.
We saw Hard Rock Ricky Blues last week in a war with Ramblin' Rich. And I got to give Ramblin' Rich credit. He came out on top to win that light heavyweight title.
He sure did. And then Agent Orange came in to steal the belt, Dave.
Unbelievable.
So once again, proving that anything can happen in the UIW.
Still trying to gain our composure after that last match. Can you believe it? Johnny Stonewall Lawler is the new UIW heavyweight champion.
Well, Dave the Wave, I'm going to have to look at that replay several times because I still can't believe
it. It's going to take a while to get used to saying that.
That's
and
true.
Not feeling funny.
And not saying, the UIW champion, Johnny Pork Butt Lawler. That's really going to be hard to do.
Fans here in Parkville Armory starting the Chucky chant for Mr. Hollywood Bob Starr. Bob, why don't you just buy a pair of overalls and complete the package? Side headlock by Bob. Ricky Blues pushes him off, catches him. Caught in a hip toss. And he picks Chucky up for a body slam.
And Hard Rock Ricky Blues is
the stuffing out of him.
Really got some power moves there, Dave the Wave. Showing some strength here early in the match, and he's going to show it to Vinny too. Vinny Beach Boy Young as he tags off to Watsumi, brings him out of the rope, sets him up for Watsumi. What a shot.
Watsumi, the Rising Sun, in control over Beach Boy Vinny Young. Judo chop, if there is such a thing. Is there such thing as a judo chop?
I suppose, Dave the Wave, if you tell me it's so, I'll believe it, okay?
Watsumi, oh, wait a minute. A rake to the eyes. Looks like Beach Boy got his fingers in that mask.
Yeah, he sure
mask
did.
Holes. He's going to tag in Chucky.
Or Hollywood Bob Starr, whatever you'd like to
I'm
call it.
I'm calling him Chucky. I don't
okay,
care.
Ooh, right.
Drop kick. Nice.
Okay. And Watsumi, he's finding himself a little bit of trouble out there. All right.
Oh, whoa.
Hard Rock Ricky
Bob
Blues
trying. Oh, that was smart.
That sure was.
Looks like Watsumi was going to pull himself up.
And it's Hollywood Bob Starr or Chucky.
Legend in his own mind, folks.
Takes time out to talk to the camera there, ladies
Hollywood
and gentlemen.
Hollywood Bob Starr.
Watsumi.
A permanent fixture here in Maryland wrestling circles. Like it or not.
Yeah, like it or not, it's right. And there's the tag off. Beach Boy Vinny Young coming back in the ring as he gives a shot to Watsumi in the rib cage there.
Across
the ring. Here he comes.
Ooh, catches him with a chop right to the chest. Cover. One, two. Two count only.
A little
Beach
too
Boy
quick
able
there.
To kick out.
Watsumi needs to go to work a little bit more here on Vinny Beach Boy Young as he moves him off into the corner, tags off to his partner. Hard Rock Ricky Blues drops him again, and here's Watsumi heading for the top
Moonsault.
Rope. He's back.
Yes.
Look out.
Ooh, nailed him.
And look at this.
Watch
Hard
out
Rock
from
Ricky
the other side.
Coming across
Whoa.
The other side. Oh,
what
boy.
Elevation on that leg drop.
And he knocks Hollywood Bob Starr or Chucky.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of your match, the team of Hard Rock Ricky Blues
there
and Watsumi.
Go.
We
got to
go back and take a look
song.
At that one, Mike. There you see Watsumi with the moonsault. And from the other side, double trouble. Here comes Ricky Blues with the leg drop.
Beautiful
your winners,
there,
Watsumi
Dave.
The Rising Sun and Hard Rock Ricky Blues.
Some beautiful moves in that match there, Dave the Wave. Believe me, the lightweights here, the light heavyweights here in the UIW are no lightweights. You can believe that. And ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with more wrestling right after this.
Hey, you, sitting there watching this pro wrestling show, did you ever wonder how guys like Kirk Dredd, the War Pig, Axel Rotten, and the other UIW stars got into wrestling? Here's your answer. They attended the Pro Wrestling Training Center in Hanover, Pennsylvania. This facility can make you the next UIW star. Call the owner, Phil Leivelsberger, at 717-633-9542 and get started in your new exciting career. Stop watching and be watched. Join the Pro Wrestling Training Center now. Attention wrestling fans, here's your chance to add all the great UIW action to your home video library. Universal Independent Wrestling is now available on video cassette. Each action-packed tape contains one exciting hour of UIW matches and interviews as seen on TV, all for the incredibly low price of $14.95. Just send $2 in a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on your screen to receive your catalog of all the great UIW action now available to you.
On his way to the ring at this time, weighing in at 225 pounds from Southeast Asia, here is Agent Orange.
And here comes Ramblin' Rich. You'll remember.
Ladies and gentlemen, his
we
opponent,
ended
the
current
UIW Lightweight Champion, Ramblin' Rich.
That's
with
right,
Agent Orange stealing
the belt.
The newly won Light Heavyweight Championship. And Ramblin' Rich, it's payback time.
It's going
as he
right
nails
at it.
Agent Orange with the belt.
As he,
Irish whip.
As he belts him with the belt. And that's
literally
what he needed.
Monkey flip.
There you go. Agent Orange is going to pay for this one.
Well, at least we got the belt back where it belongs.
I can't believe it. And the guy walks in, holding that thing high over his head, just like he won it. Well, anyway, Ramblin' Rich is is going to make him pay for this one.
Ramblin' Rich, who impressed me immensely last week in that incredible match against my favorite wrestler, Hard Rock Ricky Blues.
Absolutely.
He won the title fair and square.
Ooh,
almost
a two count there.
His first challenger, Agent Orange from Southeast Asia.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again.
Suplex coming up. Oh, no. Couldn't quite get him over, but still effective as he dropped him down onto his back.
And Ramblin' Rich seems like he suffered from that one a little bit there, Dave, the wave. In an effort for the UIW to bring the best in wrestling action, we have the light heavyweight division here.
My favorite division.
And these guys are fast, great wrestlers. Not as big as some of the other guys we have here in the UIW, but
they
nevertheless.
They make up for it in speed and aerial ability as Agent Orange nailed Ramblin' Rich with a bulldog two count only.
They certainly do, Dave the Wave, and that's why we've got the light heavyweight division here in the UIW.
Hey, maybe I qualify.
Well, Dave, you know, a couple of the fans asked me if we could get you in there, Dave. I think they remember some of your past appearances on the show there.
Double underhook, nicely executed by Agent Orange. Might have to break out the old boots, or did I sell them? I don't even remember.
Dave, I want to know if you got those trunks with the thunderbolt on it.
Yeah.
That was nice touch.
Cover, two count, two count, almost three. Yeah, you like that lightning bolt, didn't you?
Well,
this time I'm going to get a wave put on it.
I think that's a great idea. I think that's perfect. Because a lot of fans, Dave, have asked me about that already. They get disappointed when you don't get up in the ring and do the wave.
That won't be for a while down the road, maybe. In the meantime, Agent Orange going to work on Ramblin' Rich, the light heavyweight championship on the line. Ramblin' Rich, he's the champion, the challenger, Pumpkinhead, Agent Orange. Measures him and hits him right in the throat. Highly illegal, but hey, if you can get away with it and the ref doesn't see it.
He's trying to explain it away as we speak right now, and he's back down on top
rubbing
of
it in.
Ramblin' Rich there. All right, now
look
wait a minute.
As he argues with Joey DiCarlo, who's got that knee draped right across the throat. He knows every trick in the book. Agent Orange, AKA Pumpkinhead. He's mounted the second rope. What's he gonna do? Waiting for Ramblin' Rich, waiting patiently. Ooh, elbow right across to the top of the head.
And Ramblin' Rich has had a hard way to go in this match, Dave the Wave. Really has. And Agent Orange, he's just looking for that UIW light heavyweight belt. That's it. He's going to do anything he can to get it.
Ramblin' Rich draped over the top rope.
He certainly used everything he could on Ramblin' Rich.
Agent Orange literally stole the belt at the end of last week's show. He couldn't wait to get that title, even if it meant stealing it, but there's only one way to get it, Mike, and that's a three count right in the center of the ring.
That's it, David Wave. Now, I tell you, Agent Orange has been meeting out the punishment here. However, I haven't seen him go for a pin. And this may be a tactical error.
Just missing out the punishment. It could
be. I think he's enjoying that part a little too much.
Power bomb. Pop followed up by a pin attempt.
That's about the first one there in the last couple of minutes. And Agent Orange wants another count. And Ramblin' Rich kicks out again. Agent Orange trying to show Joe DiCarlo how he'd like it counted. And what do we have, a chair?
Agent Orange, no, that's a disqualification. If you want to win the title, fair and square, you can't be bringing chairs into the ring.
Look out. Comes back and hits him in the head. That's a three count.
Went to hit Ramblin' Rich. Ramblin' Rich ducked. And that chair bounced right off the turnbuckle and hit himself in the head.
Dave the Wave, I love it.
Unbelievable.
Rich.
Dave the Wave, that's from Jim Doe, our ring announcer. The final count there, and Ramblin' Rich retains his light heavyweight belt here on the UIW.
This one isn't over yet. Agent Orange climbing the top rope.
He's coming back.
The double axe handle. Where's that belt? Hold on to that belt.
Well, Dave, we got it over here. I'm going to walk over and grab this thing real quick.
Ramblin' Rich, folks, he's still the light heavyweight champion, but right now...
Got it right here, Dave driver. The Wave. Hang on to that thing for safekeeping so we don't have Agent Orange come over here again.
Well, that just about does it, Mike. I think it does.
And Dave the Wave, we'll see how Ramblin' Rich is after we get back from these messages.
Hey, you, sitting there watching this pro wrestling show, did you ever wonder how guys like Kirk Dredd, the War Pig, Axel Rotten, and the other UIW stars got into wrestling? Here's your answer. They attended the Pro Wrestling Training Center in Hanover, Pennsylvania. This facility can make you the next UIW star. Call the owner, Phil Leivelsberger, at 717-633-9542 and get started in your new exciting career. Stop watching and be watched. Join the Pro Wrestling Training Center now. Attention wrestling fans, here's your chance to add all the great UIW action to your home video library. Universal Independent Wrestling is now available on video cassette. Each action-packed tape contains one exciting hour of UIW matches and interviews as seen on TV, all for the incredibly low price of $14.95. Just send $2 in a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on your screen to receive your catalog of all the great UIW action now available to you.
Be sure to tune in for the best in independent wrestling next week right here on Universal Independent Wrestling.